Welcome back. In this video, we are going to present different types of directional couplers without complete analysis. So we are going to present these directional couplers in a qualitative form. And who is interested in studying one of these directional couplers in details, he or she can refer to the references of these couplers. The first directional coupler that we are going to discuss is a waveguide magic key, which is one type of 180 degree hybrid coupler. It is a four port network, as we have mentioned in the hybrid 180 degree couplers. It is composed of two waveguide keys. One waveguide key in H plane and one waveguide key in E plane, and they are connected together in this form. So the bar incident from port 1 is divided in the H plane in phase. So if we look at the bar incident from port 1, assuming that the incident wave is a dominant TE10 mode, such that the electric field in the y direction and maximum at the center. So this electric field at the junction will be divided into two parts along these two waveguide sections, and this division will be in phase to each other. So the output at port 2 and port 3 will have equal amplitude and equal phase. Port 4 in this case has an electric field in this direction, which is orthogonal to the proposed electric field, such that if we are looking at the input electric field here at the junction, we can see that the electric field can be divided into two parts like this. So the electric field in this direction, the total electric field in this direction is zero. It means that the electric field at the port 4 is zero. So port 4 is isolated from port 1, and port 2 and port 3 has equal amplitude and equal phase with respect to port 1. On the other hand, if the excitation is coming from port 4, port 4 will correspond to T junction in E plane. In this case, the electric field will be, for example, in this direction. And when it reaches to the junction, it will be divided. So the electric field would look like this. And when it reaches to the junction, it would be divided. The positive part or the positive potential will be the positive potential, and the negative potential will be the negative potential. So the resulting electric field at the horizontal waveguide will have an electric field in this direction for port 2, while it has an electric field in this direction for port 3. It can be noted that the phase of the signal at port 3 would be in the opposite direction to the phase of the signal at port 2. This means that the bar will be divided in equal amplitudes between port 2 and port 3, but the phase shift between port 2 and port 3 is 180 degrees. This means that port 1 in this case is the summation port, and port 4 in this case is the difference port. If the excitation is coming from port 2 and port 3 simultaneously, the summation of the signals port 2 and port 3 will be output from port 1, and the difference between the signal at port 2 and port 3 will be obtained at port 4. This is qualitatively how the magic key is working. However, practically, there should be matching stops in this junction to match these two input ports. So, in practice, tuning posts or irises are often used for matching, Such component must be placed symmetrically to maintain proper operation of this hybrid coupler. Another configuration for a direction coupler is Moreno cross guide coupler. Moreno cross guide coupler has two wave guides or signal to each other, and these two waveguides had a common wall in the intersection between them, and in this common wall we have two slots. These two slots are out of the center of the input waveguide and also out of the center at the output waveguide, and the longitudinal distance between these two slots in the forward direction is lambda guide by 4, and also here in the longitudinal direction is lambda guide by 4. The mechanism of working of such direction coupler is based on the odd symmetry of the longitudinal magnetic field component HZ. As we know, in the dominant mode, TE10 mode in the rectangular waveguide, the electric field would be in y direction, the magnetic field would have x component hx and longitudinal component hz. Both ey and hx are symmetric with respect to the cross section of the waveguide, but the longitudinal magnetic field is odd symmetric with respect to the cross section of the waveguide, such that if at the center is a symmetry line, these two slots will have equal magnitude of HZ but out of phase by 180 degrees because of the odd symmetry. So there is a phase shift 180 degrees between these two slots. On the other hand, if this slot is far away from this slot by lambda guide by 4, this means that the phase shift here will be 90 degrees from the phase shift at this point. So, in this case, if we add an additional phase shift 90 degrees here, so the total phase shift between the field, the magnetic field at this point, and the magnetic field coming to this point, it would be 180 degrees. Because here there is a phase shift 90 plus 180, and here phase shift is 0. So if we added this 90, so the phase shift of the magnetic field at this point and at this point in the upper waveguide, it would be 0. This will mean that the coupled signal due to the magnetic dipole from these two cross from these two slots will subtract in this direction, make this isolated. On the other hand, if you are looking to the other direction, we have phase shift minus 90 degrees here plus phase shift 180 degrees, and here we have phase shift 0. In addition to minus 90 degrees, we are going to add another 90 degrees to reach to this point in this direction. So the total phase shift, it would be minus 90, minus 90, minus 180, it would be minus 36. This means that the magnetic field in this direction will be in phase with the magnetic field coming from this spot, so it will add to this direction, will introduce a coupling coefficient to this port. So the signal coming from this port, from the input port, will pass to the through port, and a sample of the bar will pass to the coupled signal and is isolated from the other port or from the fourth port. This is a Moreno cross guide coupler. We say that by proper design, the two wave components excited by this aperture can be made to cancel in the back direction. The aperture in this waveguide is usually consists of cross the slots. So the type of slots is cross section in order to couple tightly to the fields in both waveguides to make it suitable for the magnetic field in both guides. Another type is Schwinger reversed phase coupler. In Schwinger reversed phase coupler, we have two waveguides orthogonal to each other such that the wide part of the cross section of the feeding waveguide is connected to the narrow section of the coupled waveguide. Once again, we have two longitudinal slots away from the symmetry line with the same distance. So these two slots have the same magnetic dipoles due to the HZ, but with a phase shift 180 degrees because the magnetic field in both sides of the symmetry are in opposite signs to each other. So the coupling between these two slots are out of phase by 180 degrees. In addition, there is a distance between the two slots by lambda guide by 4. This distance will introduce a phase shift of 90 degrees. So if the input signal is coming from this port, so some of the power will be coupled from this slot and some of the power will be coupled to this slot with a phase shift 180 degrees. This power will radiate in both directions. Now, if this power is going in the forward direction, so they are in the same phase according to the propagation, but out of phase according to the symmetry with respect to the magnetic field HZ. So they are in phase from the propagation out of phase of the magnetic field. So the total phase shift between the field coming from this slot and the field coming from this slot in this direction, it would be 180 degrees. This means that they cancel each other, or in other words, this direction will be the isolated direction. On the other hand, the radiated signal going back to this direction here and the radiated signal going back to this direction here, here it has a phase shift 0, here it has a phase shift 180 degrees in addition to 90 degrees to the lambda guide by 4. And when it will travel back to this distance, it will have an additional 90 degrees phase shift. So the total phase shift in this case would be 360 degrees. So it would be in phase in this case. And this would be the coupled signal. Actually, the mechanism of this Schwinger reversed phase coupler is the reverse for multi-hole coupler. In multi-hole coupler, the coupled signal goes in this direction and the isolated goes in this direction. Alright? And in this case, the coupling is the sensitive part to the frequency. So if any change in the frequency, the coupling will be changed, but the isolation will not be affected by changing the frequency. That's what we are seeing. This waveguide coupler is designed so that the pass lengths for the two coupling aperture are the same for the uncoupled. The pass lengths for the isolated will be the same for the uncoupled, so that the directivity is essentially independent of the frequency. Cancellation in the isolated board is accomplished by placing slots on the opposite side of the center line of the waveguide walls. These two slots are placed in opposite sides of the center line of the waveguide walls. This means that the coupling will be out of phase from these two slots, which couple to magnetic dipole with 180 degrees phase difference. Alright, another type of we still with Schwinger reversed phase shift. The lambda guide by 4 slot spacing, this distance, leads to in phase combining the coupled signal in backward direction. This comes from what? We have already 180 degrees between these two slots. In addition, the signal from the second slot to reach back to the first slot, passing lambda guide by 4 once and lambda guide by 4 back, it will introduce an additional 180 degrees. So the total phase shift between the two signals from the two slots in this direction, it would be 360 degrees, which correspond to 0 degree or in phase. So the lambda guide over 4 slot spacing lead in phase combining at the coupled or backward path. But in this case, the coupling is very sensitive, is very frequency sensitive. So any change in the frequency will change this lambda guide over 4, so it will change the coupling coefficient. And as I said, this is the opposite situation from the multi-hole waveguide coupler which we have discussed before. Another type of coupler is rebuilt short slot coupler. Rebuilt short slot coupler is composed of two waveguides in parallel to each other are connected through a slot in the narrow wall. And this slot is actually with the size of the wall itself. The mechanism of this waveguide coupler is that the original waveguide section is operating at the mode TE10 mode. At the coupling section, these two waveguides are connected to each other, so the wide waveguide section can operate in the mode TE20 mode. TE20 mode, it means that we have some power in this waveguide will be transferred to this waveguide. And in this case, the TE20 mode is asymmetric. So in this case, the electric field is positive at this section. It would be negative at this section. So we say that it consists of two waveguides with a common sidewall. Coupling takes place in the region where part of the common wall has been removed. This part. In this region, both TE10 mode, which is even mode, and TE20 mode, which is odd mode, are excited at this region. By proper design, can be made to cause cancellation at the isolation port here, the isolation port, and addition at the coupled port. The main critical point in this case is that in this coupling section, it is not required to excite TE30 mode or other higher order modes. So the total waveguide section is reduced at this part to avoid exciting higher order modes. So the width of the interaction region must be small enough to prevent the propagation of the undesired TE30 mode. Effectively, the main advantage of this coupler is that this dimension is independent on the length in terms of guide wavelength, so it can be made smaller than other conventional direction coupler which require, for example, lambda guide over 4. So this coupler can usually be made smaller than other types of waveguide couplers. This is rebuilt short slot coupler. Another type of coupler is symmetrical or symmetric tapered coupled line coupler. We have already studied the tapered coupled line coupler and we studied the coupled line coupler. But in the tapered coupled line coupler, it was an asymmetric. It was connected from one side by a constant characteristic impedance Z0 and from the other side with tapered coupled line coupler. On the other hand, for the coupled line coupler, we use coupled line section in for exciting both sides, the input and the output. For the tapered coupled line coupler, we are combining the structure of the tapered coupled line and the coupled line coupler. So in this case, it is symmetric structure with tapered coupled line section in like this configuration. Actually, the advantage of using this symmetric تيبر كابل لاين كابلر is the wide band operation and the matching impedance. So multi-section coupled line coupler can be extended to a continuous taper yielding coupled line coupler with good bandwidth characteristics. In this case, both conductor widths and separation can be adjusted to provide synthesized coupling or directivity response. As in the conventional coupled line coupler, which provide 90 degrees phase shift, also symmetric tapered coupled line coupler provides 90 degrees phase shift between the outputs. But in the case of an asymmetric tapered coupled line coupler, it was a hybrid 180 degrees coupler, not 90 degrees phase shift. Okay, so this is another configuration for tapered coupled line coupler. Another type of coupler is coupler with an aperture in planar and thin planar line structures. Effectively, we have studied how to connect to waveguides by multi-hole structure. In a similar way, we can replace the closed waveguide by printed line structures like microstrip line structures with a common holes or holes in the common ground plane between the two microstrip line structures. Also, we can couple microstrip line structure to a waveguide through holes in the common ground plane between the microstrip and the waveguide. Also, we can couple a microstrip line structure with a dielectric image waveguide through holes inside a common ground plane like this configuration. These are different types of aperture couplers for planar line structures. Effectively, the analysis of such planar line structure is slightly complicated compared with closed waveguide, but the basic idea is nearly the same. Okay.